This Week in Fish and Wildlife, sponsored by your local Montana Toyota dealers.
Thursday morning, time once again for This Week in Fish and Wildlife. We're out and about in Region 3 with Andrea Jones this morning. Andrea, events happening this week, kind of a stark reminder of things we've been talking about many times in this week in Fish and Wildlife segment.
Right, you've been helping us get the word out on CWD and a lot about aquatic invasive species, and so we're ramping up into that spring season when people start bringing their boats back to the Northwest, people from out of state, and we had an incident last Friday where our inspectors at the Anaconda inspection station found a boat carrying many, many zebra mussels, which we know can be very damaging to our resource. So that boat was actually on its way from Ohio to the coast of Washington. So we've informed the folks in Idaho and the folks in Washington, and obviously we did our best to clean the boat at that point, hot scrub it. And just a good reminder that sure, we're looking for them, but it might be easy for some of that stuff to slip between the cracks. And speaking of cracks, that's where the stuff, they're in crevices. It's hard to spot them sometimes. We're talking, you know, top of your pinky size mussels that we're looking at here. I mean, those are the ones that you can actually see. Right. So it's really important that we follow that protocol of clean, drain, dry. If they're dry, and these mussels were probably dry at this point, meaning they really didn't pose a risk, but if they are, you know, if there is still moisture in there, they can still support life, and we don't want them reproducing in our waterways. So clean, drain, dry, really helpful.
I do know that there's procedures in place for people that are regular taking their boats on the waters and things like that. You're making that a little bit easier for them.
Right, especially in Canyon Ferry, for example, which is in our area. There, we do have the certified boater program. We've now moved that online, so it is a little bit easier. So if you are someone who really just frequents Canyon Ferry in the summer months, and you don't want that, you know, to have that intense inspection every time you go in and out, because that is required, then you can go online, get that sticker for your boat, and it'll expedite that process for you each time, because if you're not moving to another waterway and you're sure you're just going to stay at Canyon Ferry, then that's okay. You'll get that boat sticker, and it'll expedite your inspection and your conversation with our staff.
It seems to me the events happening in Anaconda here last week, maybe it's a marker of change of mindset as well. This is something that isn't a hassle. This is something where these inspectors can be super helpful as well, because they're able to look at it with a fresh set of eyes as well.
Well, we're protecting our resource, not only ours, we're protecting, in this case, Washington's, hopefully. You know, these can clog up the infrastructure of, you know, irrigation. They can wreak havoc on our fisheries, so we all want it, because, you know, it's no good if we're not going to be fishing at Canyon Ferry for the things that we like if the fishery's gone.
Perfect. Again, Andrea Jones from the Montana Department of Fish, Wildlife, and Parks.
This Week in Fish and Wildlife was sponsored by Toyota. Let's go places.